What do you keep in your earthquake preparedness kit?
Earthquake preparedness kit?
Yes, sir.
I don't have an earthquake preparedness kit.
Phyllis, what do you keep in your earthquake preparedness kit?
Oh, gosh, I don't have one.
Why not?
I don't know. I never really thought about it before.
I'm not gonna be afraid of something that may never happen.
I think people kind of need something to kind of get them in the mindset a little bit more. I mean, I'm not prepared.
A lot of people don't even realize that we get earthquakes in Oregon. This used to be the place that Californians moved to get away from earthquakes. Boy, are we fooling them, because we have the potential now for an earthquake larger than anything that they'll ever get in California. Millions of square miles will feel this earthquake. And as it moves up the fault, you've got the primary waves that are radiating out, and they'll be felt within minutes.
I'm James Roddey. I'm the Earth Sciences Information Officer with the Oregon Department of Geology. And I've been at this for 10 or 12 years. Some people call me the prophet of doom.
You can imagine, we're standing in a park right here. Nice green park, pretty beautiful city behind us. And so imagine that it starts with a rumble and you begin to feel things kind of rocking and rolling and you're thinking, oh, well, this is very strange, but it doesn't go away. And you can hear groans and roars from the bridges and the buildings around. And now we're 2 or 3 minutes into this event, and it keeps going, and it keeps going. And you think it's never, ever going to end.
Get set up for your talk?
Something like that. They realize that there is an earthquake on the horizon, or at the coast, earthquake and tsunami on the horizon. And they want to know more. They want to know what they can do. So that's why I stand up in front of people, is here's what's going to happen, here's why it's going to happen, and here's what you can do to get ready for it.
So I would like to introduce our prophet of doom, James Roddey. Thank you, James.
Thank you, Linda. Thank you very much.
Okay. We tell coastal communities, plan on being isolated for a couple of weeks before help starts to arrive. All the help's coming to Portland and Seattle and Olympia and Tacoma and Vancouver and Victoria and Eugene. That's a lot of people to be helping. The resources of the United States will not be enough to respond to an event like this.
Do I think I'm saving lives? I would imagine, in a selfish sort of way, I would say yes, I probably am saving some lives. But that's really not the goal. The goal is to work with these communities so that they can save lives in their communities. Mine is kind of just the technical message of, here's the geology, here's what's going to happen. And it's really up to the communities themselves to decide how to use that information.